Hi,
AT from CNC at home. A couple videos back, I was doing a coaster where I had multiple items that I put on and layering them on top of each other, and found out that when you do layering, it doesn't work kind of how you might think it works, how you would do it in an editing program like Photoshop, where anything that's behind is covered by whatever's in front of it. If I were to move that, it would look something like this. That doesn't affect how it burns other than the order that it burns. When we do a preview, we can see that we still see all these circuit pathways, even though the laptop is technically on top of all of that. So what we did was I drew some lines to kind of see where I needed to cut, and then I went through each one of these individual items on the circuit paths and trimmed them, added lines, closed them off, got them back so that they would fill. Within LightBurn, there's a feature that I knew about and I kind of forgot about for this. It's called Cut Shapes. And I want to show you how that works. It makes this particular project way easier to do, way faster. We start out the same way. I'm going to switch layer. Well, I'm going to draw lines and I'm going to switch layers here to the green layer. And I'm just going to draw basic shape of the laptop. And I do that so that I have something to trim to. I just click here. And this last one, click to make sure that it closes the shape off. We can see that it's closed it by turning fill on, and our whole shape then is filled. We will leave that as a line though. Let's remove our image. I'll just hide that so we don't see it. Now what we can do is we can select these circuit pathways as the item we want to cut. And then by holding the shift key and selecting this green outline that we created, we go under tools, select cut shape. Because the items we're cutting, which are circuit pathways, the blue ones, we had it set to fill. LightBurn knows we want to keep it as a fill, so it closed off each of the items. Now it kind of looks the same at this point, but if I select just in the middle here, I can shove all that onto a different layer. So you can easily see that this stuff is on a different layer, or is a separate set of entities. I can turn them off. I can move them. And what we want to do is delete them. Now when we go to print this or burn this on the laser, we don't get that ghosting from behind because there's nothing there anymore. We've deleted it. So that's way faster, more accurate maybe even, than doing the way where I went into each one of these entities and I trimmed them or deleted, added, worked with the entity nodes for the vectors, then added lines to close these off. Not the easiest way to do it, it works. Using this function under tools called cut shapes, way easier and does such a great job. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, think about giving it a thumbs up. That helps the analytics within YouTube to help drive more people to see our videos. And if you like the type of content that we create, think about subscribing and enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.